What up guys, it's Vico Kang here. In today's video, we're gonna walk you through the lead nurture process, which means getting the prospects as close as possible to pre-sold mode before speaking with you and your team, right? And we're gonna outline the exact lead nurture process that we use personally in our own agency. There's actually many ways to do this, to do lead nurture, but we're just gonna show you the way that we use it personally because that's the way we know best, all right? So this is gonna be a short one just because that a lot of this process is gonna be automated using GoHighlevel. So first thing first, we're gonna go through the book, right? The recommendation book, right? We recommend influence and story, building a story brand, right? And these two books really helped me a lot when it comes to building your personal brand, which is requirement when it comes to lead nurture, right? So we're gonna do a little bit of a recap here. I'm gonna zoom in a bit. We're gonna do a little bit of recap. Now the system should be like this, okay? You're gonna have ad on the left hand side, you're gonna have outreach message, and then you can have outreach message also, but in a VSL outreach, right? You're gonna go in, get your objective is to get them to the book call, right? But not everyone will book. That's why the phone scripts in the previous lesson, very important. If you have the phone script, you can recover all those lost lead. Now, when they book a call with you, this is when the lead nurture process happened, right? You can see the black square here and the red arrow. This is when the lead nurture process happened, right? Between when they book and when you have a call with them, there should be 24 hour to 2 day or even 3 day max, right? You know, including Sunday and Saturday. That's when it's actually happened. So in its most basic form, the lead nurture process is getting a stranger to know, like, and trust you a lot more, right? So when you actually cold call them or when they see you on an ad or YouTube, right? Let's say they trust you at a 6, right? Depending on your content or whatever that they see beforehand, it's a 6. When you put them through the lead nurture process, hopefully we can get them to an 8 or a 9 before they speak with you. And the reason why we're doing that is obvious, right? It's gonna help make your life a lot easier. You don't have to repeat a lot of things, right? Example of what you do, and you don't have to do much of a convincing or persuading or selling, right? You want to let that process do a lot of heavy lifting for you. And the good news about this is that we're going to teach you how to automate the whole thing, right? So there's many ways you can do this, right? You can do it through your story, which is come in a form of copy or email, right? Copy in an email or VSL in a video. You can do it through client story, right? Client story, the before and after interview. You can do it through testimonial and case study, right? And you can do it through PR, right? Market authority, okay? So this is how you set it up, okay? We normally use two way. Actually, we use both way, right? To set it up. Number one is what we'll use a short term trip for immediate fast nurture. Now this is the one that you see here, right? So when we actually book a call with somebody or when they book a call themselves, right? It's 2-3 day or even 4 day until the call happened, right? Until the call actually get attended, right? In that day, we actually send them lots and lots of short term interval, like short interval email and SMS, in a form for testimonial and case study, right? And our story as well. We're gonna show you how to do that. And this trigger based on when an appointment is booked. So when somebody book an appointment, I'll show you that right now. You can see here, this is our workflow inside, one of our business. You can see here, after the appointment confirmed in this calendar, right? In all of this calendar, it actually removed them from all of the workflow, right? It removes them from all of this workflow, and it's gonna do the boring stuff like update opportunity, assigning, like all this stuff is not really relevant. But what happened is that it's going to add them into this nurturing before demo workflow, right? I'm gonna show you what that workflow look like because it's gonna add them. So this is like an operation workflow. It's just removing people, adding tags and all that stuff, but it's add them to this nurturing workflow, and this is what the nurturing workflow look like. We'll name it like really simple. We just call it realtor nurturing before demo, because it's exactly what it do, right? It's exactly this workflow. And you can see here, we wait 7 minutes. So after that, they book, right, an appointment with us, 7 minutes before the first email go out. We don't want it to be instantly, right? I just say, hey, glad you, hope your business is doing well. This is Martin from Area Specialist, case study here. And when they click the link, it's go to our website, which have a little bit of a storytelling. Let me see if I can do it right now. I don't think I can do it right now, but it's pretty much just go to our real estate website that have a little bit of story and case study and all that stuff that walk them through our process. We also including our process in the video as well. Just want to make sure that we don't have to repeat ourselves a lot in the demo call, right? When they come into the call, they have an idea on what the process look like, okay? And you can see here, the wait time is 15 minutes. 15 minutes, then they get another text, right? They don't get email, but they get text saying, hey, I want to come in and show you again. So I'll just like show you guys this page here. This is the page. So we'll send them a combination of email and SMS. Now, the reason why we're doing that, guy, is that when you try to nurture somebody, you want to hit them from as many directions as possible, right? Just in case the email doesn't land. Ideally, you want to hit them from Facebook and YouTube as well, right? If you can. But right now with GoHighlevel, from what our current setup, we only sending them SMS and email, right? When you nurture them, you want to hit them from as many directions as possible to make sure that they see your message and increase that likelihood of you closing the deal. So we send them to this page. It have story, it have a story video of me telling them the process, warm them up, telling them our testimonial, the brand that we work with, all that stuff. Now, if you're our elite member and you're watching this, you're gonna have access to this, right? We're gonna show you how to set this up. Anyway, I'm using our testimonial white label, okay? So, you can see here, the next wait step here, the next wait step is 24 hour, right? And the next wait step is 8 hours. So you can see it's very short term. It's very short time interval. And I switch between email and SMS, email and SMS, email and SMS. You get the point, right? It send them to different link, different case study, different video, right? Now, how do I get here, right? I'm actually, when I first start, I want to add some point here. When I first start, guys, it's very, it's a very short sequence. It's like one SMS, it's like two SMS and two email. But as I go on, as I get more wins and I get more testimonial, I literally come into the same workflow and I add an email and I add an SMS. And before you knew it, it get very long, right? So when you get win, just come in here and add it as you go. It as you go campaign, right? It's not gonna be finite, right? It's not gonna be limited to what in here. So this is our short form trip campaign, and it's in this one. Now what we have as well is our long-term trip campaign. Now this is dominantly email based, and this is what it looked like, okay? And we trigger based on a website opt-in. If someone come into our website, they just searching, they just checking you out, this is what's it for. Or when a contact is become lost or non-buyer, like if we speak with them, they don't want, like they're not ready yet, they're not ready to commit, or they don't want to do anything right now, we'll put them into this campaign. Now this campaign is a lot softer and lighter, because it's just email, it doesn't have SMS, because it could be expensive there. And which is, I think it's every 7 day or whatnot. You can come in here, you can see here, we add tag and we're doing all this fun stuff. The first one is two day. You can see here, two day again, and then 2 day. And then we actually change that to 7 day, I think. I keep doing 2 day. It's depending on how many email you got, but it's actually changing to like 7 day. Right, I think we actually changed to 7 day at some point. So we'll start off with two day, three day, and then 7 day. I think that's how I remember it. But you can see here, most of the content is dominantly email. And again, right, from it's long form and it's more like storytelling and brand building just to get them to like trust. You can see here, if you think McDonald's is a burger business, think again. If you think Apple is an iPhone, is a phone business, think again. If you think Recline is a marketing and social media management business, think again. The world has changed, and the biggest and the largest company on the planet right now is have data or are data driven. Google is data rich. Amazon is data driven, right? So it's like, you know, when I have time, I come in here and I write a little bit of copy and storytelling and add them to nurture and warm up my audience in a form of long form copywriting, right? Like I said here, I write this day by day based on wins and day by day based on win on the weeks or day. It could be story or win or something that inspire you. This email is really not so much of result driven, just like the short term email. I'll show you another example here. You know, I say here, once there was a hole, I walked a path. I didn't see the hole. I fell in the hole. I got stuck inside for a very long time. I blame the hole for all it did to me. The next day, I walk in the same path. I see the hole. I still fell in the hole. I got stuck for too long. I blame myself for falling to the same hole twice. The next day, I walk in the same path. I see the hole. I go around the hole. I'm glad I did. Right? So it's like a little bit of a I did not use ChatGPT for this. It's actually on that day, long time ago, on that day, I saw a story and I feel inspired and I come sit down and write the email and I add it to the sequence. Now it's gonna serve me forever because it's in the sequence and everyone that come in gonna be repeatedly getting that sequence, you know, on their 12th day or on their 20th day, right? Hopefully that makes sense, guy. Now, what I normally do with loop like this is with email like this is I'm gonna put them in a loop, right? Because when you send an email one time, it could land on spam or they might not be opening it. So I'm gonna have like 50 strings of email and I'm gonna put it in a loop. There's actually a YouTube video here that I'll show you how to do that. It's just two workflow that you connect, workflow A and workflow B, and you connect it and it's become an infinite loop. So that means people will keep receiving your email indefinite until they're ready to book a call with you. That's why when someone book a call with us, we'll remove them out of all this workflow so they no longer receive it, okay? So this is our long-term email trips. I recommend that you work on your short-term first, right? And then your long-term email is something like you can add once a week or once a month into your sequence, and then it's become longer and it become an infinite trip for people who's not ready to buy or people just want to check you out, right? So now I want to show you something before I finish this off, right? This is it, right? Content is one of those medium that act very strangely. It's actually giving you a compound effect because you can see here, we can zoom in. I'll try to zoom in again. If you're actually making content, guys, here, if you're actually making content, let's say on YouTube or on Instagram or on TikTok, it's actually act as lead nurture and lead gen at the same time, right? So people can saw your content, and if you have the right call action, they will book a call with you and jump to a sales call. Now it's such a huge shortcut. You can see that comparing to this message or comparing to the ad, you have a longer step, right? A longer process and a longer, I guess, workload. But if you make good content, it actually act as lead nurture on the front end, right? And also act as a lead generation. People will book a call with you, which aka lead generation, right? And the people that coming in from content, they're a lot warmer, like us, right? We have YouTube channel. People that come from our YouTube, when they speak to me, like they already know me. They like bench watching all of my video. It's just like one of the most easiest conversation. It's like pleasing conversation that I can have. Like I enjoy talking to my YouTube subscriber. I really do. Now, the reason why we're not going to any detail on how to set that up is because I don't have a million subs yet. I'm not an expert on that field yet. I'm still in a process, at least of at least at this time of recording, I'm still growing and I'm still testing different things to grow my YouTube channel and my Instagram page, right? And a lot of you watching this, you probably come from my YouTube and my Instagram, and really thankful for you to be following me this far into this course, into this video. But unfortunately, like, it's not my field of expertise. Hopefully in one day, once I feel comfortable enough to make a lesson about how to grow on this stuff, because I do want to hit like some sort of like big number before I start teaching it to other people. But we're actually doing this right now, and I can tell you it's far more better than ad and outreach and all that stuff, right? Just because that people are coming to you with like literally $0 ad spend. And it's, like I said, it's ACAS lead generation and lead nurture. It is not beginner friendly. It requires so much work in terms of copy, scripting, editing, and all that stuff. So I don't really recommend that if you're just starting out, you do this. No, not at all. Not at all. Just follow the course, right? Get on with the ad, get on with the outreach, and get your client.
Hey guys, if you enjoy watching the video, make sure that you're also checking out this content right there.